Next is John from Visalia, California, listening on Immaculate Heart Radio. Welcome, John. What is your question, please?
Okay. Well, first off, I'm reading this book by this guy by the name of Jimmy Akin called The Fathers Know Best. So I had a lot of questions, but I'll boil it down to this one.
Okay.
Since, and I had a whole title for this, but I will let all that go. Anyway, since Jesus states that you must eat his body and drink his blood to have life in you, those who call themselves Christian who reject that, don't believe in the Eucharist, don't eat the Eucharist, and don't have life in them, then how do they have life in them, and then how are they going to be raised on the last day? So okay. I'm a Catholic asking for a Catholic answer to that one, because reading Fathers Know Best brings up a lot of really hard questions for people to answer.
Excellent, John. Thank you.
So there's really two questions there. The first one is, the second one is, how will they be raised on the last day? Well, everyone's going to be raised on the last day, both the righteous and the wicked. So everybody's going to get raised. The question is whether people who don't receive the Eucharist at least sometime during their lives, are they going to be saved? Now, in John chapter 6, Jesus does use this language of, if you don't eat my flesh and drink my blood, you have no life in you. But he's talking to people who he has preached the truth to, and they've deliberately rejected it. They've said, we're not going to follow you. We don't believe what you're saying. We're utterly rejecting this. And if that's something that you do through your own fault, then you are indeed rejecting salvation on the terms that God is offering it. And so that does imperil your salvation. But there's a famous quotation attributed to St. Augustine where he said, we are bound by the sacraments, but God is not. And so God is able to give his grace to anybody regardless of whether they have been able to receive the sacraments or not. And that's obviously the case with respect to the Eucharist if you simply look at all of the righteous who lived before the time of Christ, because none of them received the Eucharist. So God can obviously save people by giving them his grace, even if they don't have the opportunity to receive the Eucharist like those people did not have the opportunity to do. And the church has looked at that and said, okay, well, if through no fault of your own, you aren't able to do the things that are ordinarily required for salvation, like repenting and being baptized and receiving the Eucharist, then God won't hold that against you. And as long as you otherwise cooperate with the light and the grace that he has given you, then it's possible for you to be saved. And so other Christians who don't have a valid Eucharist or who never received the Eucharist out of ignorance, as long as they're innocently in that condition and they're otherwise cooperating with God's grace, God will make sure that they're saved.
Do you have a quick follow-up, John, before we go to break in about 90 seconds?
Okay, so a lot of Protestants have, okay, Jesus told the bishops, he who rejects you rejects me. He who hears you hears me.
He didn't say
that
to the...
A lot of Protestants call in and...
Hang on, he didn't say that to the bishops. Bishops were not yet instituted in Luke chapter 10 when he said that, but it is a principle that applies to Christ's church generally, so go ahead.
Okay, well, it just, ultimately, if I'm Mr. Protestant and I hear the Catholic Church tell me this is the body of Christ and I reject that, then to me, I think you're putting yourself up there for a jump ball as far as where am I going, you know?
Okay, I'm not sure that I'm familiar with the phrase jump ball, but I'm guessing it's maybe
a basketball
term.
It's a basketball reference, yeah. It's a start play.
Okay, but what I would say is that merely the fact that someone tells you the truth doesn't always obligate you to believe it. If there's a madman, let's say I've never heard the gospel before. I live in some remote part of the world, and a guy comes up to me and he's clearly crazy. You know, he tells me that birds, you know, live underground and fish swim in the air, and Jesus is the Messiah. Well, he told me the gospel, but he told it to me in a way that put me under no obligation to believe it, because he's clearly a man of unreliable judgment. And in the same way, many people may have heard the truth, whether about the church or the Eucharist or Jesus, but they heard it in a way that didn't impose a burden on them to believe it. And so it's only those who are at fault for rejecting the truth that imperil their salvation. If someone innocently doesn't believe the truth through no fault of their own, then it's still possible for them to be saved.
Does that work, John?
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much for calling.